फिशन। इफ यू सी द स्लाइड्स, आई एम प्रोवाइडिंग द स्लाइड्स अलॉन्ग विद दिस वीडियो, सो यू कैन हैव अ लुक एंड यू विल हैव अ मोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द स्लाइड्स एंड द फिगर्स। सो फ्रॉम अ वन पेरेंट्स देर इज़ अ नंबर ऑफ इंडिविजुअल्स डेवलप इन अ पर्टिकुलर सैक और इन अ पर्टिकुलर area, that's why it's called as a multiple fission. That means organism have the potential or the ability to develop a number of organisms from a single parent or the number of individuals from a single parent, that's why it's called as a multiple fission. For example, plasmodium, that is a malarial parasite. Next one, budding. Everybody knows about the budding. It happens in a hydra and the yeast. So in this process, the bud-like projection is formed on the body of the organism. For example, consider the hydra. The bud-like projection, that means a bud. For example, this is the hydra. A bud-like projection occurs, start to develop at the particular point, that is at the eyes. We can say like this. It's just like a sugar cane. As we cut the sugar cane and graft into the soil. Same like eyes on the part of the body of the hydra, it start to develop in a bud. Then this bud then develop into a new individual. Then the bud has the totipotency capacity. That totipotency means it has the potential or the capacity to develop new individuals. And the budding. In budding process, in this method, the bud-like projection is formed on the body of the organisms. Then this bud develop into the new individuals. After the maturation, the bud has the capacity to detach from their parent. Again, it acts as their own parent. It happens or develop in a hydra and the yeast. Next is the fragmentation and the regeneration. See, do not make a confusion between the fragmentation and regeneration. In fragmentation, the simple multicellular organism break up into smaller pieces on maturation and each fragment develop in a new individuals. For example, it happens in the spirogyra and the flat worm. In fragmentation, the organisms the simple multicellular organism, it break down in a small pieces upon the maturation. For example, wall lizard, in generally in local language we call it as a pal. The wall lizard, when upon the maturation, it loses its tails. After breakdown of its tail, it has the potential to develop again a new tail. And in it, after a few days or after a month, again we can see the completely grown tail with the wall lizard. That is called the fragmentation. But keep in mind, it happens upon the maturation only. One more thing, upon the maturation, as it happens upon the maturation, so if that a particular fragment breakdown from their parent, the broken part have the ability or the potential again regrowth as their parents. That's why it's come under the fragmentation. In regeneration method, the part of the body, if the organisms, if cut or broken, can develop into a new individuals. For example, it happens in the planaria or starfish. In a planaria or starfish, it lives under the water. So because of the natural activities, for example, maybe the fighting of the organisms under the sea, maybe the storm, these organisms may get broken down, break up in a small pieces. That broken part again have the potential or the ability to develop into a new individuals as their parents. So this is regarding the regeneration. So again, I would like to tell you, please do not get confused between the regeneration and the fragmentation. In fragmentation, the individuals break down upon the maturation and that broken part have the ability again to regenerate into a new individuals. But in regeneration, the body part of an individual get a break or the cut because of some accidental activities, and that broken part have the ability to develop into a new parents. If you have any queries regarding this topic, so please text me my personal number. The WhatsApp number is given in the official group. And thank you.